Hey everyone, I'm Mariana, and in today's video, I'm going to be talking about my top five movies that I watched this winter. And if you missed my top five books that I read this winter, which was my last video, of course, it will be linked in the info box below along with everything else. Now, if you've seen my fall top five movies, you will remember that I only included movies that actually came out in the fall. But this time around, I decided to include all of the movies that I watched this winter. However, it turns out that all I've been doing for December through February is catching up on 2017 releases and a couple 2018 releases, and then rewatching old favorites. Obviously, I am not going to include rewatches in this because that's just an unfair advantage. It would just be a top five of my favorites here, but it did end up being mostly 2017 releases anyways. But for the future, just know that I will include anything and everything I watched throughout the season. All right, let's get into the top five. So at number five, I actually have a 2018 release, and that is Annihilation, written and directed by Alex Garland. I do have a separate review for this movie. If you missed it, you can check it out. But basically, this is a sci-fi thriller slash horror film, which is loosely based on the novel under the same title by Jeff Vandermeer. The movie revolves around a group of scientists going into this unknown area referred to as the Shimmer that has all kinds of strange biological occurrences going on. It is a film that is hard to explain without spoiling it, and a lot of it depends on the unknown, so I'm not going to tell you too much about it. As I mentioned, you can watch my review. As a big fan of sci-fi horror, I was really looking forward to this film, and I am so glad Alex Garland did not disappoint me. I got the science fiction from it, I got the mystery, I got some really disturbing stuff, the visuals were beautiful, and as it should have, it did turn out to be the kind of film you want to keep talking about and theorizing about, so I was pretty happy with how everything worked out. It wasn't a perfect movie. It did have some pacing issues and some things didn't quite come together, but in general, this was a very memorable experience and something that was quite different from a lot of the films that I've seen recently. And speaking of different, at number four, I have Thelma, which is a Norwegian film, and it is a coming-of-age story of its own kind. It does feature a young girl who is going to university. She's going away from her family for the first time in her life. Her family is very religious. It's quite a complicated situation. And she starts having these strange seizures that may or may not have something to do with special abilities. This is the perfect kind of film for someone who wants to see a different spin on a coming-of-age story. It is absolutely gorgeous visually. There are quite a few scenes that really stood out to me that I don't really want to ruin. There is some very strong, striking imagery in it, and I thought the story was fascinating. Just like with Annihilation, it did have some pacing issues and some of the story didn't quite come together as well as it could have, but it is once again a very memorable experience. This is kind of a theme with me in general. I want the films that I watch to be memorable. I don't want them to just be a pretty well done thing that has been done before. No, this is different and I really appreciate it. I will say that this movie could turn out to be a little bit frustrating to someone who wants definite, clear, satisfying answers to everything. It's not that this film doesn't provide answers, it's just that some of it is left to your interpretation, but you can see it as a completely metaphoric kind of story. You don't have to take it at face value, it's kind of left up to your interpretation. interpretation as the viewer. And once again, it's the kind of thing I like. At number three, I have The Shape of Water, which is the latest from Guillermo del Toro and is a very much talked about film at the moment. It is absolutely gorgeous. If you have seen it, you know that the direction and the cinematography of The Shape of Water is just out of this world and very reminiscent of classic creature feature Hollywood films, but also completely unique to Guillermo del Toro. You can absolutely tell that it's one of his films. For me, this was all about the setting and the color palette and the way del Toro presents this fairy tale for adults. The only complaint I had about this movie is that I prefer characters that are a little bit more complex than the ones that were in The Shape of Water, but at the same time, this being a fairy tale type story, it kind of makes sense why the characters didn't have a ton of depth. This is also going to be a big hit for anyone who's a fan of classic Hollywood films because there are a lot of references and homages in The Shape of Water, and it is the creature from the Black Lagoon done Guillermo del Toro style. So if you somehow haven't seen this movie, I think it is absolutely worth checking out. I don't know if it's still in theaters, I doubt it, but if you can find it, then definitely see it on the big screen because it is stunning and meant to be seen in the theater. For my number two, I am going with The Disaster Artist. Yes, the movie focused on Tommy Wiseau and The Room. I absolutely loved this film, and if you've seen my top 10 movies of 2017 video, you've already heard me gush about it, and you already know how surprised I was by the fact that I loved it. I expected this movie to be a little bit too silly. I expected it to lean on the comedy a lot more. I did not see it coming when it started going for friendship and relationships and dreams and believing in yourself and trying to make something just because you have a passion for it. I honestly never had interest in seeing The Room until I saw The Disaster Artist. Now I kind of want to see it, and I went on a huge interview binge with Tommy Wiseau after watching The Disaster Artist. It is a fascinating subject, and it really made me emotional about the characters and about the whole situation, and I did not expect that at all from this film. So if you have any doubts, if you're like me, if you think this may be a little bit too silly or just poking fun at this guy who made a really bad movie, no. Give it a try, it's going to surprise you. And for my number one, I just can't go with anything other than Loveless. I will not shut up about this movie until everybody watches it because it is such a great and such a dark but important drama about two parents who are getting a divorce and their son overhears their argument and disappears. It is heartbreaking, it is a tough watch, but it is an excellent, excellent film. I know I keep saying I'm going to make a review of it, and I will make a review of it. The only issue with that is that the things I want to talk about are kind of spoilery, and obviously it doesn't really help if I talk about spoilers because most of you have not seen the movie, but I will be filming a review. I promise. This is a Russian film from one of my most favorite directors working today, Andrei Zvyagintsev, and he is a master at showing complicated and messed up relationships between people. He is a master at this sad but important social atmosphere, and he presents it so well in this film. It can be tough to digest, but it is absolutely worth checking out. Here he combines the mystery of this missing boy with making you absolutely repulsed by the relationships these people have. It's not something you want to believe exists, but you know that there are families like this and you have no idea why they live like this and how they got there. You just want to hug your family after this film because you know that this is the life you don't want. So that's it for my top five movies that I watched this winter. Let me know what your top five looks like for the winter in the comments below. As I mentioned, doesn't have to be movies that came out in the winter, but generally your recent watches and what were your favorites. And of course, if you've seen any of these movies that I talked about, let me know what you think of them in the comments below. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up, share it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Also, hit that notification bell so you don't miss any of the future videos, and I hope you're having an awesome day. I will see you soon in my next one. Bye!